students. Today we will learn about fundamental theorem of calculus. In our previous lectures we learned about vector differential operators. Now we extend our study to the fundamental theorems related with them. As the first one, we discuss the fundamental theorem of calculus. That is defined as, if you find out line integral of a differential, integral a to b, df by dx into dx is equal to f of b minus f of a. This theorem is called fundamental theorem of calculus. Okay? So what is the geometrical meaning of this theorem? Because you know that this integral is along a line. Okay, its lower limit is a and upper limit is b. Then we make this line segments, each segment of length dx. Okay, that means we have a function f of one variable x. Okay, f is a function of a single variable x. Okay, now we want to integrate along a line a to b such that each segment of length dx. Okay, so if the x varies from x to dx, that is, if x changes to x plus dx, f changes from f plus df. Right? Okay, so this corresponding increment in function f. If x incremented by an amount dx, there is a corresponding increment in the function df. Actually, this integral is the function df. Okay, so if the independent variable x varies by an amount dx, the corresponding variation in the function is df. Okay, so if we move from a point, suppose this is the point, this is a and this is b, and we move from a to b along this line, then each segment is like this. Segment of length dx. Along this length dx, our function varies to df, f to f plus df. Okay, so if you integrate this function like this, it will give you the value of function at the upper limit, f of b minus f of a, f of b minus f of a. This is the geometrical interpretation of this line integral. Either you can go by step like this. Each increment dx, this corresponding increment df. Then you can add each df together. Then you get f integral a to b df. Or you can find out value f of b here and minus f of a. That also gives you the same line integral. Okay? So, from this theorem of calculus, what do you get? We already learned about line integrals. Okay? There we said that if line integrals are depending on paths. Okay? Line integrals depends on paths. So, what happens? Line integrals depends on path means if you integrate from A to B through this line, it is differ from this line. It is differ from this line. Okay? Then how this thing is correct? This is because here, this even here we discuss the differential of the function. Okay? If you call this df by dx as capital F, you can write this equation as integral a to b capital F of a. x dx equal to f of b minus f of a. Okay, here let capital F of x equal to df by dx.
T of B minus T of A. Okay? So, some
dl1 is shown here, dl1. Okay, this is point A and this is point B. Along this line we integrate. So up to dl1, the change in this function t is given by gradient t. Okay, so gradient t dot dl1. Then if you take next variation as dl2, it is given by gradient t dot dl2. Okay, then what we get? If we take these segments like this and find out the variation in function t and summing up all these, you get the same result. That is what we show here. Integral A to B, gradient T dot dl1. This is one, dl1. This should be equal to the value of the function at the boundaries, at the upper limit B and the lower limit A. T of B minus T of A. Okay, so what is the peculiarity of this line integral? Here, the function, gradient function, is path independent. Line integral of gradient is always path independent. Okay, that's why you get this line integral as the difference between the endpoint values, t of b minus t of a. Okay, so our conclusion regarding this fundamental theorem of gradient is that gradient, the line integral of gradient, okay, line integral, line integral of gradient, line integral of gradient is independent of path chosen. Independent of path chosen. Okay? So the fundamental theorem of gradient states that integral A to B, gradient T dot dl1 equal to T of B minus T of A. Its effect is that the line integral of gradient is independent of path chosen. It depends only on endpoints. It depends only on endpoint values. Endpoint values. Values of the function. Okay, now suppose that we have closed the line integral. Okay, close the line integral, gradient T dot dl. What is this? This is a closed line integral. So if you start from this point, you have to return back to this point again. Okay, so your upper limit and lower limit both are same. So this difference gives you 0. Next, we can do a problem. So the question is given here. Let t equal to xy square. And the point A is given by the origin 0, 0, 0 and the B is given by 2, 1, 0. Check the fundamental theorem for gradient. That is the question. Okay? So now, we know that the fundamental theorem of gradient states that integral A to B, gradient T dot dl equal to T of B minus T of A. Okay? So, in order to verify this theorem, we have to find out line integral. of this function and the direct this difference, we have to compare the result. That is what we want to do. Okay? So, now to evaluate this LHS. Okay? We have to select some paths like integral A to B. In order to evaluate this line integral A to B, we have to choose a path. Right? For that, consider this x, y coordinates. Okay? A is this point, which is the origin. A, 0, 0, 0. Now, B is lying somewhere here. Okay, B is lying here. B. This is 2. It is given that B equal to 2, 1, 0. This point is 1. Okay, now, suppose we choose the path like this. For evaluating the integral, we chose the path like this. Okay? Let this segment is 1 and this segment is 2. Now, if you done your integration along this path from A to B, you get an answer. If these two are equal, you can prove that this fundamental theorem of gradient is right. Okay? Okay. So now, what we want to do, first we have to find out this gradient t, that is what we want to integrate. Okay? So, gradient t means y square x cap plus 2xy y cap. Okay? Dou by dou x of xy square. Dou by dou x of xy square is y square. X cap. Then dou by dou y of xy square. It gives you 2xy y cap. This is gradient t. What about this dl? dl? dl, here we can write this as along this line. We have to find out dl along this line. Okay? So, actually this is dx x cap plus dy y cap along this line. Along line 1. Okay? So, for evaluating LHS, integration along path 1. Okay? Integration along path 1. Here there is no y. Y equal to 0. Okay? So, dy y cap, there is no this term here. So, dl in this case along 1, dl is equal to dx x cap. Okay? So, gradient t dot dl equal to, gradient is this one. If you take its dot product with this, you have y square dx. Right? Y square dx. Now what next? Next thing is that this y square, y equal to 0 along this line. This is the x-axis. Y equal to 0 along this line. So this thing goes to 0. Okay? So from here to here, this line integral is 0. Now we want to find out this vertical line along this path, line 2. Okay? So along line 2, what happens along this line? Here dx equal to 0. Okay? Along this line, plus dy. X equal to 2.